I got my Bulls hat. I got my X-Men shirt. It's Saturday. I'm gonna go hit some thrift stores. All right, I can't tell you guys how happy I am hitting the thrift stores. It's been over a week since I've gone thrifting. The last week I took all off because my son had spring break. I decided I was gonna list stuff around my house, just get caught up on a lot of different items around my house, around reselling business that I needed to take care of, and I just put off thrifting. All I did was leave the house to ship stuff and then just come back and work on my business. But my first store back, it was so much fun to be back thrifting, hitting the stores, and actually finding some stuff as well. So I'm gonna show you what I got here. First item today was a Wii, just console only, but for $6.49, that is a great price. That is a bread and butter item for me. I found this cable. This goes to a drive to connect to your computer. And this one is sealed for $2.49. That should give me $30. You know I love my media. I found Teletubbies DVD. That should go for about 15 to 20. For this one, Secret of Stretching, only of one have sold, but there are none listed. So I'm gonna be the only one up there. And the last one that sold went for $35. And this Garth Brooks DVD CD set is a rare one. It's like the Susan Komen set, the pink one. I've never found this one before, but I found this for 99 cents. And recent one, it sold for $40 used. And I see one up there for, I think, $80 new. So I'm probably gonna put it at like 60 bucks new and see if I could get it sold pretty quickly. That's a great way for me to start off my thrifting adventures again. It's great to just get back in the mix of it. I'm gonna head to the next one. Hopefully the luck continues. All right, quick in and out. This one, I got three items. I got this cool David Carradine Tai Chi Workout for Beginners DVD. Look how cool that is. Even calls out that he's the star of Kill Bill. But we all know he's from Kung Fu. But this one is for $2 and it'll typically go for, looks like I could get like 20 for it new. Four line, this one is always a bolo for me if I get it cheap, especially if it's new. These ones with the 3D version inside has the glasses in it. I usually get like $17 to $20 for them new. Now I got another copy of Return of the King. I always put these in sets for myself. This one I got for $2. I actually just sold a set of the trilogy for $45 today, and I already had the other two ready to go, so I need this copy to complete it. So I'll put another one up probably as I go over to the next store, because now I know I have another set to list. All right, got a nice little haul here from this last store. I spent like $19 or $18 altogether after rounding up. Found Pio for Beachbody. This will go on Mercari. That will go for about $20. I found this Yahtzee Gold Edition digital game. This one goes super quick for me. This will usually get me about $20 free shipping. Lastly, I found this Country Legends Live set. There are 11 DVDs here. The set includes 12 of them. These are all sealed, and the only one I'm missing is Volume 1. Which I feel like is a good volume to be missing, because I think I could get that one pretty cheap on eBay and get that shipped out to me for, you know, like $5 or $8 or something like that altogether. But this whole set altogether, someone had sold it for with 11 DVDs, with one missing actually. They were missing like volume 7 and they were all used. It was like 120 bucks. So I'm gonna buy that other one, put it in this set, and I don't know, aim for like 180 or something like that, since it's a brand new set, and try to aim high for it. So cool little pickup right there. I've never found these before, never tried to sell them, but looking at the comps of what you could do when you get the whole set, or at least close to the whole set, looks pretty good. So we'll see how that one does, but for, you know, right now I have like $12 into it. It's not really a bad deal right there. All right, a quick in and out here. I found this Final Four DVD. It's sealed. I believe it's Kansas beating Memphis. That one should go for about 20. Karate for Kids, that one should go for 17 to 20 as well. I found these two games, Carnivores 2 and Carnivores Ice Age for the PC. It looks like I could get about $30 free shipping for these combined. Then I found this rare one. It is I Was an Atomic Mutant. This one has only sold once in the US, there's none listed, and it was sold for $45, but it was with the big box, I believe. There's what the disc looks like. But this is common of how it is being sold, like this. And the only other ones that are out there are over in Europe. So I don't know. I'm not sure what I'm going to price this one at. I'll probably put it at, I don't know, 35 or 40 and just see if I get an offer on it. I only paid $2 for it, so just take a chance on it, see how it does. I always like taking chances on like weird computer games that don't have anything available over here, just to see if there's a collector that wants it, or maybe it's just like super rare and it'll sell immediately after I list it, or it could sit for, you know, 12 months. I don't know. Take a chance on $2. Let's see if I hit that lotto ticket. All right, this last store that I just got out of was really good for me. I spent $20 even there. I got another Return of the King that will go to building another set. Simpsons Season 8 sealed. This one should go for about $25. Guitar Hero 1 and 2 for the PlayStation 2. That should go for about $15, maybe a little more. West Wing Season 7, this one is used. This one should go for about like 20 to 25 as well. So this Sony VCR, I paid $449 before 20% off, so it's less than $4. This one just sold, I think today, to someone else for like $100 without the remote. So I feel comfortable picking this one up even without the remote, especially since the VCR, most people with VCRs, they just turn it on and let it go. So not too worried about that. So that should be an easy, at least $90 on there for me. And the real cool find that I had are these two copies of Marijuanaopoly. It's build your own legal cannabis board game. So this is actually pretty cool. Each of these were $3.49. They're both sealed. None are listed. One sold back in December. The only sold that there is, or maybe it was January, and it was for like $45 or $50, and it was a new one. So this one, I'll give one to my wife because I think she'll want one of these because she's actually in the industry. And another one I'll sell. Unless she wants to give it to like one of her coworkers as well. So pretty cool item right here. I'm hoping I get to play at least one of these because it'll be a fun Monopoly game to play. So I'm not sure why someone turned in two of them. My wife doesn't want either one of these. I should make at least $100 off of it when I sell them individually. Maybe I'll even put it up for like $60 since no one has them listed, and you know, just see what I get for them. I already got a text back from my wife on those two board games. She said she's keeping one for sure, and it's okay to sell the other one. So I think she wants to play it or be able to bring it to work and show it off at least to her coworkers. So it's always fun to find cool items for yourself, especially when it's cheap. That was like $3.49 before my discount. So nice little find there, and keep the wife happy. All right, I'm gonna share with you what I found at the last two stores. I spent, I think, 12 at the previous one and 11 at this last one I went to. The first thing I got was Test Drive 4, and it's sealed. Though the box is beat up, if you could see in there, it's already punctured there, and the plastic in the back is torn, so I don't think a collector is really gonna want it. Though the ones that have been listed are listed really high for these. So I'll put a price up there, I don't know, $40, and see if someone wants it. Otherwise, I'm gonna just put it in my own collection because it's a cool looking box and I love the big box games. Found another Beachbody set size. This will go on Mercari. This always gets me like $20 to $25 on Mercari, pretty easy. I got this box of sealed floppy disks. This was $2.29, and it looks like I could sell these for about $25. I got this Sony Handycam for $5.49. It didn't come with a charger, but I believe I have this charger at home. And if I need to get one, it's like $5 or $6 as well on eBay. But this one should go for about $60 with the charger. Another cool item that I got was this Adobe Creative Suite 5 Master Collection. This is a student and teacher version. The non-student teacher version goes for like $250 or more on eBay. The problem is with these, you cannot sell the student and like education version on eBay. I got a Vero from it, like after having it listed for one day on a previous one. So you want to put these on Mercari or anywhere else, maybe Facebook as well. But this one does have the code in it, so someone's going to have to go in if they're a student and, you know, register it as a student. But it is super cheap for them to do it this way versus, you know, buying the regular version. So So at the last store I just went into, I got this Psychopharmacology Academy like DVD set or CD-ROM series. Only one had sold. None are listed right now, but the one sold like yesterday. And it sold for like a best offer. They had $50 up and they sold it for a best offer. So I got it for $429. I feel like I'm gonna be able to get at least $40 on it. Maybe I'll put it at $50 and see if someone buys it. I'm not sure how long the other person had listed for, but I feel like I could get a good price on it. I'll check Amazon as well. Maybe it's a little bit better priced on Amazon. Now the last two items I got from the store were both board games. It is just like a board game type of day. Both of these are sealed. I got a Monopoly Wizard of Oz one. It looks like I should be able to get like $80 to $100 for this one. And then I found this Pursuit of Par. This is like from, looks like 1986. And it's still sealed. It looks like some type of like, you play golf at home. Now the box is really heavy. But this one will fit in one of those like priority game boxes, which is like large flat rate. I think I'm gonna price this one around like $100, maybe $130, because there's none of these listed that are sealed. There's another one that's like a TPC Sawgrass one, so it's like an alternative version for this one, but I think that's a newer one. This is definitely an older one versus the ones I saw listed up there. So I'm gonna put it high because there's nothing else that's listed out there, and I'm going to set the market, see what it goes for, and if it doesn't, I'll, you know, send some offers out to people watching it. So that's everything I got today. It was fun picking up all those board games. That was definitely the highlight of my day, finding those four sealed board games. It's always fun to find those and flip those. Hopefully I get some really good premium prices on those. I know my wife's gonna keep one of them, but the other three I should make some really good money on them. Thank you guys for joining me once again. Make sure you hit the subscribe button down below if you haven't already. I put out 2 to 3 videos a week. So if you wanna see them in your feed, make sure you hit that subscribe button because it'll be there right away. And as always, I'll see you guys next time. Bye.